Hey, and welcome to the Pop Recap episode number 6. I am Fly Guy, and with me, as always, is Mr. Art Kane. Good evening, sir.
Good evening. No, this is not take two. Don't worry about it. Haven't had any technical difficulties. This is the first shot. All good. Yep.
We do it live here. Ton of stuff. It's been a while since our last show. Funko went a little quiet and then suddenly blurted a ton of stuff. We're going to go straight to it. There's so much stuff to cover. We're going to share everything with you on screen. Everything that we talk about will be in the show notes underneath pretty much everything. So if you want to see a product, you want to buy a product, you want to look more, click the links underneath in the show notes. And we're going to start off, first of all, very first thing we have, and we were just talking about this off air, was Uncharted, one of the coolest games we've both had a play of before. And a couple of variants we've got in these Nathan Drake figures. Blue shirt, brown shirt, and one with a Naughty Dog symbol on the chest that's turning up. This is turning up here as a non-exclusive. You were saying it's, you think, EB Games and Target over there for you?
Yeah, the blue shirt's Target, and the brown one, I believe, one of the other ones is GameStop, I think. My only issue with it is they've got different colored shirts. Big deal.
It came with something else, a little, yeah.
Yeah, well, the dude is never not sweaty, except for, like, when they're showing him at home at the very beginning of the game. Then after that, he's drenched in sweat. Like, I want some sweat stains. I want a 5 o'clock shadow. Like, I want the guy to look like he's been running around in tombs. Like, exactly. I mean, I 3 years ago wouldn't have been picky with my pops, but now seeing what we got, I don't think it's asking too much for a sweat stain. So.
No. Because we really want sweat stains in our pop. That's what we really want. So.
Hey, if it could smell like shit, that'd be great too.
Well, scented pops, that's one that's we're going to get to later on. We'll come back to that. But yes, so there you go, Funko. Give us sweat stains. No, really good. Another one that seems to have caused a bit of a fuss for a lot of people. People lose their shit when it comes to Spider-Man. They really, really do. I mean, it's cool, but it's like Spider-Man, Hawkeye, brand new poses of these characters and two keyrings makes a very bizarre kind of package, don't you think?
Yeah. Let's just say what everybody's thinking. That's some bullshit.
Well, I mean, they're brand new molds.
But they are, no. Don't get me wrong. They look great. That Spider-Man is awesome. But why do I have to get the two keychains no one wants to get it? Like, that Spider-Man would have been perfect in the Civil War box, but no, we got another Captain America and Iron Man, which I'm sure you were fine with another Iron Man, but some of us are sick of Iron Man.
Yes, I would have been fine with another Iron Man, but an Ant-Man would have made more sense. Maybe even a mini Quinjet or something. One of the little tanker that Iron Man throws or something. That would have been perfect, but very weird set in some ways. But yeah, I know a lot of people are buying it.
I really like the Spider-Man though. I really, really like it.
He's pretty cool. He is pretty cool. So that's going to be a popular one for a lot of places. Pretty much everybody has it up for pre-order. So Dr. Toys, Entertainment Earth, BBTS, everybody you could think of has it. Pop culture. You can go and get it there. What else have we got? We have a couple of other images that popped up here. And in our show notes, we had a list there just of some of these new Spider-Gwen pops. There's been a lot of stuff being shared by these guys. Pop Wars. So I'll go back down. Excuse us if there's any noise issues. I seem to be picking up a lot of noise in this call. But there we go, Spider-Gwen. Spider-Gwen unhooded. Not sure how I feel about that one. Exciting for you?
Nope. I mean, I'll probably get it because it's if it was a glow-in-the-dark regular Gwen, I would just get one Gwen. But she's unmasked, so I might have to get that. And she is about to usurp Deadpool as... Yep. The most overrated pop culture Marvel character. And I know I saw the other day, I don't know if you saw this, they did Gwenpool. Have you seen that?
Mm-hmm.
Dear God. It's like, what's the two most popular things we have? Spider-Gwen and Deadpool.
I know.
Let's throw Wolverine in there too somewhere. I don't know.
Yeah, it's well, you know, people are going to be buying it and they're gonna go nuts for it. But yeah, you're right. It's a little we're kind of sick of the Spider-Gwen stuff, I think. But then again, the sales might be doing good, so
Yeah, and I was kind of, I'm harsh on it, but I have a friend, his little girl just loves her, so I think that's more so like it's somebody for little girls to have, like they have their own Spider-Man now. So I mean,
true.
that's cool. But it's
Yeah.
oversaturating the market and I don't want to see it.
Well, talking of oversaturating the market, Funko, no strangers to repainting something and just rolling it back out once more. Yet again, have done it with this. I mean, we've had the original Cap in this mold. We've had US Agent in this mold. We're now getting the Sepia Tone 75th Anniversary Amazon exclusive, which is not an exclusive overseas, but for Amazon it is. But I think I'm going to skip on this one, but it's a nice looking paint job. Not sure about you.
Boring.
Boring.
I mean, if it was a Captain
It's
Hydra,
always.
it was a
No,
Captain
true,
Hydra.
true.
Spoiler alert for those
Funko.
of you who don't have the internet.
Exactly. I
Oh,
think, honest.
look,
Go on.
they dropped the news the same day DC did their rebirth. It's nothing but a marketing ploy. And if you're sitting there at home going, "Oh my God, I can't believe Captain America's a Nazi," you're out of your mind. Okay, Captain America's not a Nazi. This will all be erased in 6 months, and no one will give a damn, just like now. I mean, they revealed the Joker's identity, and no one even, I still don't know who it is, because I don't freaking care. So, and I'm a huge comic book guy. I love DC, but I don't care. And
People are
he's Hydra.
losing their shit over the Hydra thing. It's like, come
I know.
on.
And it's just, all it is the Marvel guys, Brian Bendis, Joe Quesada, Steve McNiven, Mark Millar, they're just giving you guys the finger, and you're rushing out people that have never, that don't buy comics. They're gonna go and buy this and put it next to their Death of Johnny Storm, and their Death of Superman, and their Death of Batman comics, and they're like, this is when America died, man.
Yeah, that's true. That's true, actually.
Captain
Yeah,
America's a Nazi for 75 years. You guys are outside of your friggin' minds.
you have to give them credit. I mean, 60-odd years of comics. I mean, things can get boring. They have to come up with something
Yeah,
original and
no,
different. So, I mean, it's.
I love it because it's got everybody in such a tizzy, like just going crazy. Like when they put blue jeans on Superman, like
I know, that was another.
how could you put blue jeans on the all-American hero? That's just crazy. What that an American would wear blue jeans.
Well, I mean, each to their own. We all have something we lose or kill about, and this was one that really I was super excited about. Of course, the repaint Voltron, an Anime Expo exclusive metallic version, but that just looks sick. I really do like
Yeah,
that.
that's
That's
really awesome. Hey, maybe the con versions will have a decent paint job.
Yes, that's true. People, if you want the blunt truth about Funko, you come to this podcast and our camera will really tell you how it is.
Dude,
But you're right.
I swear to God, I have looked at 40 different Voltrons and still not found one with a paint job. I don't give a
Yeah.
shit if the box is torn to pieces. Give me a decent paint job, please.
Yeah, that's true. I've seen a lot of them myself and they've been pretty shoddy in a lot of places. But that is a nice looking little job there. It's certainly metallic really works well with Funko Pop, in my kind of humble opinion. But that's a nice one there.
The
So.
only thing that would make that Voltron better is if it was 6 inches like it should be.
Yeah, that's a good point, actually. That's a good point. They should have made it a 6-inch pop. Very good point. All right, carrying on with other news and other bits and pieces. Wubba-lubba-dub-dub, probably one of the best shows I have ever watched, ever. You and I are both big fans of this. Rick and Morty Pop finally bringing this to the screen. Very, very happy about this. I just hope they do more. A lot of people are like, who? What? God,
Yeah.
you gotta go and watch this show. You have to watch this show. So both Rick and Morty, and just watch episode one to see what he does with these things in his hands, and you'll be hooked like me. But I'm super happy. I can't wait for the day. There's one of the characters for people that don't know in Rick and Morty called Mr. Poopy Butthole. I can't wait to get a Funko Pop in my hand, Mr. Poopy Butthole, or see this on websites. That's just yeah,
I
so
want a
good.
Mr. Meeseys as well.
Yes,
And
true. Mr. Meeseeks, yeah.
Hot Topics showed a Rick. They're gonna have an exclusive Rick. I think he's gonna have. Oh, he's got the gun, the portal gun, and he's got
Oh,
speed.
nice.
So, yeah, that
Damn, there we
I
go.
will. I will, if I have like $9 left to my name and I see a Rick and Morty pop, I'm buying it. Like, I need those. Like, I haven't won, and I love my pops, and I haven't wanted pops this bad in a long time. They're just perfect. They are perfect. And I want a spaceship. I want a spaceship pop ride. We could do a whole show on Rick and Morty pop. I'm not even kidding.
No, that's true. There's so many characters. They get an alternative Ricks and alternative Mortys. And...
Exactly.
Yeah.
I hope somebody buys 1,000 Ricks and just makes all kinds of Ricktators.
So yes, definitely highly recommended. But both Arkham and I, go and buy Rick and Morty pops. Click the link in the show notes. Go and get them. That's a great show. It's on Netflix now, series one. So definitely worth a watch.
I've only watched it like 12 times.
I know. So another one, I know a really, really old animation character way back in the 60s, cheesily awful, Space Ghost, if anybody remembers that. Do you remember that show? Have you ever seen reruns?
Oh my god. Yes. I am so freaking excited about this, man. You know what this means? You know what this means? We could have a Harvey Birdman.
That's what I thought it was at first, and I was like, "Hold on, that's Space Ghost, but it's it's the same mold almost."
Not a Harvey Birdman, just a Birdman from the Hanna-Barbera, and then I can make a Harvey Birdman. But yes, Space Ghost, super pumped about that.
Exactly. There's a really Dark Side Toys. I get this up, and they've got a little link underneath there to the old cheesy intro, and it's so bad, it's brilliant. It's 1960s.
No, it's amazing. Amazing.
It's just so retro and so cool, but a lot of people will be like rubbish, but it's cool looking little pop. But
yeah, and if you like Space Ghost or if you want some serious Space Ghost, Alex Ross a couple years ago did a 4-part series of Space Ghost that was like serious. Freaking awesome. Did you read that?
Really? No.
Yes. Alex Ross.
Okay.
Yeah.
A lot of other stuff out for pre-order. We'll maybe catch up on some more of this stuff in a minute. But a lot of new stuff turning up. Star Trek Beyond, brand new range of pops. Kirk and Bones and Spock and Scotty. And I don't know. I'm not too fussed about these myself. I guess that's a no from you.
I just saw the Star Trek preview this weekend. Mm-hmm. And... if I didn't know that Simon Pegg wrote most of it, I wouldn't go see it because the Fast and the Furious director is directing it. But since Simon Pegg wrote it, I will go see it.
Yeah, me too.
I'm just wondering if he gave it all he got.
I hope so. The the Enterprise blowing up again. It was just, I don't know, Star Trek. Anyway, if you like Star Trek, there you go. I'm actually seeing a lot of older Star Trek pops turning up in stores, a lot of like the original Kirks and Spocks, mm-hmm. and all. I don't know what's going on. Maybe they're coming out the woodwork because of this film, but a lot more out there. Just while we're here, we'll just keep on sharing just that screen. They've also got some other cool stuff. Spider-Gwen, of course, Keating. This guy looks cool. The Flash Zoom looks a very cool pop. I pre-ordered one of them. I don't know quite why we need two Speedies from Arrow, but we're getting one with a sword and one without, and a brand new Arrow and Pete's Dragon.
Yeah, Pete's Dragon.
For you?
Awesome. Yes, Pete's Dragon for sure. And then the Flash Zoom. It's just really cool.
It is. Very, very. I love the detail they've got on the mask. Just really, really nice kind of sinewy stuff on the mouth. The way the characters kind of parts are. But yeah, really cool looking Zoom. And if you've watched the latest season of Flash, it's... you'll find out what happens to Zoom, so he should be kind of popular as well, but I'm sure we'll get some variants depending on what happens. So no spoilers there, but a couple of other cool things, just while I'm here, one thing has turned up. We do have a picture of this. I'll try and share this later on in the show, but there is another Deadpool coming out. There's a previews exclusives with suit and tie. I don't know whether I shared this with you, but I'm sure you've seen it. Have you seen the little image of this, the Deadpool with a suit and a tie?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's pretty friggin' cool.
Deadpool, so...
Yeah, but it's different. It's different. It's not like that Hot Topic garbage we keep getting. Stop it, Hot Topic. Stop it.
Yeah, that was a cheap one. But then again, they did that with Batman. Entertainment after that with Batman, the multicolored, endless Batman figures and endless keychains. So,
well, they did do that, but they said, here you go. You can just buy it. it doesn't have to be in some garbage mystery box, and then all the people bought all the Mad Hatter ones or Mad Caps.
Yep.
And they weren't even variant. So it's like, okay, you just bought the stores out, but you didn't buy a variant. You didn't get the variant one. So congrats.
Definitely the variant thing is a big issue. And I see a lot of, again, in the land of no exclusives here where everything is available pretty much. Just keep an eye on some other sites out there. I mean, again, don't limit yourselves to Hot Topics and EEs and all this kind of stuff. You can get this stuff overseas for a little bit more, but none of the hassle. None of the hassle. So, yeah, keep your Funko cart open to some overseas stuff. Some more stuff came from Funko. Just sharing out some of the stuff again in the notes here. This, I had to get one of these because I'm a Pac-Man freak. Little Pac-Man pocket keychain. I'm loving these keychains. I blame you for this bad habit, actually.
What did I do?
You told me to unscrew the little things out their heads, and basically you've got a mini pop, and damn it, I had to collect them all. So yeah, very cool. Nice little bunch of keychains from there. Skipping on the show notes a little bit, there's a TV show, just where we were talking about TV and games earlier on, TV show that's just kicked off in the US. I don't know if you had a chance to catch it, Preacher? I'm sure you've read the comics at one time.
Yes, I have read the comics. I have not watched the show yet. I do plan on watching it. But yeah, Preacher's one of my all-time favorite comic books ever.
Very, me too. Very, very cool little bunch of pops have came out there. We've got three of the main characters from the show. Jesse, the Cassidy, which is just, he's a killer in the opening of the show. And Arseface. Which is just genius. Just genius. So again, if you're not familiar with Preacher, the comic, definitely get started in the graphic novel straight away, and the TV show is coming thick and fast. Next episode in a couple of weeks. But a great looking bunch of pops. Very happy with these, actually. So looking forward to adding them. What else do we got? Independence Day, the Resurgence movie. Not so fussed myself, but if you're a fan, we get Thor's younger brother, Jake Morrison. You get, what's his name? The Fly actor, Jeff Goldblum. David Levinson. We get another one of these alien warriors, which it's not bad, actually. It's kind of cool. Nice paint job on him. Comes with a gun this time. Don't know if you're going to pick up any of them or care. So should be sharing them there.
Yeah, that's it. I can't see them. So.
Yeah, Jake Morrison, David Levinson, this cool little alien warrior.
Yeah, that alien looks pretty cool. Yeah.
I do like that design. Certainly milking the design as much as possible. Another kind of curious one as well was American Horror Story, Hotel, I think that's season 4, I think. This is the Lady Gaga version, so I'm sure she's popular and going to sell. So yeah, if you're not a Lady Gaga fan or American Horror Story, that's another bunch of pops. Funko doing a great job of actually communicating out what they're releasing, unlike Hasbro. God, Hasbro's been sucking recently. At least we get from Funko, they give us little reveals. Cameron and the other lady often reveal on their tweet streams, live videos, Periscope, Twitter, they announce stuff, and they put it in the blog. They're so good at communicating stuff. So very, very grateful to them for sharing out some of this stuff, because there's a lot of pop out there, and it's really hard keeping tabs on this stuff. What else have we got? Funko Fundays. Have you ever been to Funko Fundays, or know anybody who's been to Funko Fundays?
Yeah, I know. Couple of guys that go, but they live in California and New York where this stuff happens. So
I think we talked about this a way back in one of the earlier episodes, but Funko Fundies is just insane. If you put this into YouTube, you'll see what they do, but it's just this Funko frenzy that goes on. It's kind of scary. It's like Black Friday times 10, but Funko Pop.
You would not believe the stuff that they have. Like, there's 1 in 6 Freddy Funkos and stuff like that. Like, it is insane, the rare stuff that people could pull out of there.
Well, I think what's nice is at least they've made this available to the public. You do have a chance of getting a ticket. $120 though, plus fees per ticket. That's a pricey event. This isn't in San Diego Comic-Con, it's just around that time, but that's it. You head along to the Grand Hyatt Manchester in San Diego, and Arkham saying, you get a lot of freebies and stuff given away, but as you've seen, or you know as well as I do online, I mean, they literally throw them into the crowd. It's not like you get a goodie bag with a guaranteed amount of stuff.
Yeah. Well, The pictures I saw from the old school Funko Fun days, there was like 13 people there. That was the one I would want to go to. Now it's just like a bunch of zombies at a feeding frenzy. Like,
yeah,
all you posers.
Yeah, kind of crazy. Some other known Funko Pop stuff that came out recently, and looking very cool, actually, a nice range of mini mysteries was the Bethesda Mystery Minis, basically Fallout and Uncharted all mashed up into one, which is kind of cool. So, although Uncharted isn't, oh, that's further down, sorry, my apologies, the Pocket Pop, but Bethesda, the Fallout 4, and I think, is it Warcraft, or one of the other Warcraft games? I can't remember. Doom, Doom is one of them.
Fallout, Doom, Skyrim, I think. Those are Skyrim. Yeah, Skyrim.
Skyrim. So, yeah, they're kind of cool. I like these. Nice little, good-looking little pops, variety. Yeah, little Doom characters and other stuff. Another keychain, unlike the T60 kind of... Sorry, that is the T60, but unlike the generic power armor, this is a slightly different one. And we also get a little Uncharted pocket pop keychain too. So, there's just no shortage of stuff coming. It's like... And there's people out there who actually really do try and collect everything by Funko, and I don't know how they do it. I really don't know how they do it. But there you go. We covered the keychains earlier on. What is next? Oh, T-shirts. This is something I forgot. There's a lot more T-shirts. We talked about this the last time, but if you haven't been made aware, there's a ton of T-shirts out there. I've got six of these ordered because I just love them, but... you're looking at BB-8, Boba Fett, Star Wars, there's Marvel ones in here too, Captain Marvel, Captain America, Hulk, Deadpool, tons of stuff. So, are you a fan of these? You bought any of these? I think you bought one to the Punisher.
Yeah, no, I love them. I was going to say, I saw there's a new display at Target today that I saw that had a Batman and Robin shirt that I'm going to have to get. They had a new Captain America, another BB-8 shirt, other than that one, a First Order Stormtrooper shirt, and it was a big display, and it had a bunch of minis, and it had pops on it, so it's just a whole Funko wall. So instead of an end cap now, they have an end cap and 4 feet. But yeah, no, I love those pop shirts. I can't resist them, especially when they go clearance at Target.
Yeah, I know, really annoying. I know, kind of odd sizes that went on clearance, but still, it was nice to see the fact that...
Well, yeah, let's see. I think my dad has all the Deadpool ones, all of them. And then I have the Punisher, the Daredevil, Ant-Man,
Ant-Man.
And a couple others, and I actually have the very first Funko Pop shirt from Target, like, years ago. So, it's just got Batman on. Yeah, I got it right here. Do you want to see it?
Go for it. Sure, if you can. Six. I did not realize they did a T-shirt way, way back.
Yeah, there's actually... Wave 2, there's actually a few, because they did them to lower marketplaces. But,
Okay.
Yeah. That's
wow,
the first.
Oh, there you go. Didn't know that.
So,
nice.
But yeah, and like random stores got them because it was before, I think it was before Funko, that's an official Funko shirt, but I think it was before Funko copywrote some of their art and people were just snagging it.
Copying it. Yep.
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah, well, they're very collectible. The cases look beautiful, and they get that little pop standee too. So yeah, I'm well into double digits of t-shirts. So yeah, my wife's like, "What are you doing?"
I don't think I have enough personally, but I have a lot of t-shirts. So
yeah, I know. My t-shirt addiction's bad enough without Funko coming along. But yeah, they're very cool, very collectible. Some really good ones in there. Definitely go in and get your sizes as quickly as you can. But yeah, check them out. Now, Pop Asia, this is something that's a little unusual. I came across this the other night just in Amazon looking for some stuff, and this caught my eye. What an abundance this seller had. Again, link in the show notes. An abundance of really cool Pop Asia. So Pop Asia is the Asian division of Funko Pop, and literally you get the Asian market kind of style of characters that you just will not get here. But I loved some of these. They were really cool. I don't know if you've ever seen any suppliers in the US that stock these that you know of, or but I thought the prices were reasonable for very rare pop.
Yeah, there's a couple of eBay sellers in the US that have some. I actually have one of the Pop Asia one. I have the Hanuman, which is an Indian god, I believe, or Korean. If I'm wrong, don't freak out. But yeah, it glows in the dark and everything. It's pretty awesome.
These are
And
very cool.
the zombie ones they've done, I mean, those would sell like crazy over here. I don't know why they're not over here.
I know, I don't get it. Maybe it's a license thing. Could well be a license thing,
There's
actually.
a yeah,
But
there's a 6-inch one that is really, really cool. That actually Toy Tokyo had. So if you're in New York, there's a chance you can get these at Toy Tokyo.
yeah. They're just beautiful. I know my wife, she's a bit of a pop collector, but kind of on the fringes, not as nuts as me, but she would love these little cute Japanese kind of things. I mean, they would sell so well over here. Well, everywhere really. So just gorgeous. Very, very unusual and very different. And this seller just seemed to, yeah, it is pricey, $30, but again, I've never seen these. And probably by the time you import them somewhere, it costs you a lot of money. So yeah, definitely check them out if you're interested. Some really unusual ones though. Just a few, there we go, there's one other one. Astro Boy. So yeah, unusual kind of cool pop. Always on the lookout for that stuff. If you see it, let our Kim and I know. Leave a comment in the show below, and just tell us if you find some unusual stuff. It's always good to see the rare stuff other than the commons. Now, Suicide Squad is coming, looking to me to be one of the best films by DC I think ever made. And geez, old Funko Pop are really, they're laying into it heavy already. We're seeing a lot of this stuff already. Harley Quinn in a gown is turning up. Not too sure I really care for that one. But there you go. Harley Quinn's kind of like Spider-Gwen and Deadpool. We've got a Joker turning up with a tux on, looking very cool. And another bunch on the back of the box. I'm sure you've seen this as well. But Joker, Harley Quinn, Deadshot. Now we know there's an alternative Deadshot too. There's this
Good
kind of masked.
Lord.
I know. Did you see this? No. I love the Enchantress. She's very unusual. That's going to be a very heavy pop.
Yeah.
But this looks to
I'm
be
glad
the.
they're making Enchantress because on the stinking Periscope the other day, all I kept seeing was Enchantress, Enchantress, Enchantress.
Oh, really?
There she is. Yeah.
Yeah, there she is. So
Oh,
this
it's
looks
way
to be, to me, to my eyes, and correct me, anybody, or you, Arkham, if I'm wrong, but that looks to be the complete list so far. I don't think there's any more variants that I've seen.
I think
You've
that's
got,
everybody.
yeah, the tux, the Hot Topic, this is a Hot Topic exclusive as well, but there's pretty much all of them, I think. The Joker is a boxer, Harley Quinn inmate, Killer Croc boomerang. Yeah, we're gonna get some more. I'm sure we'll get blood splatters, and they're gonna milk this thing. So, but yeah, very cool, very kind of cool film. And already we're hearing things like there's a Harley Quinn spin-off movie and all sorts of stuff. So,
Oh.
I know, I know. It's just, hey, look, you know, if there's money to be made, these guys are
Yeah,
gonna
well,
make it.
this movie's going to be successful whether it sucks or not, because
It's
Harley Quinn
true.
is in, and the Joker. So,
And the Joker, Batman. True.
and I don't think this is going to be the best DC movie ever made.
You don't think so?
You're talking about in the
Couldn't.
like in the DC universe, because if I can jog your memory and recall the
Okay.
Christopher Nolan trilogy, is that excluded from
Oh,
what you're saying?
okay. Touché, touché.
Yeah.
That aside. That aside. That
Okay.
aside. Yeah. It's certainly Green Lantern, but that's another conversation. But yes. Talking of different variant pops, this sometimes Funko release stuff that I'm just like, this is just a turd. And to me, this is a giant purple turd. Why?
Let's box lunch. Nobody even knows what box lunch is.
I know, I know. It's this company has. I think they actually are. I think you told us before something about a division of Hot Topic or something.
Yeah,
I don't
they're
know
on
what
the
they
Hot
call it.
Topic. Yeah.
Bizarrely, they have a gigantic purple Regina. I guess in some point in the TV show, Once Upon a Time, she turns purple or something. I don't know. Yeah, so I think they're kind of milking this one just a little bit. But
Well, Box Lunch has to do exclusive pops because this stuff they sell is really, really overpriced and expensive. So they have to sell that kind of stuff to make up for their profit margins that they're not getting. There's only like two stores, two
yeah,
brick.
that's there's one in Florida and one somewhere else, I don't know. So, but they do ship in the US, so if you really want a Regina, but I've already seen this overseas here in places like Pop Culture and stuff. So, Don't sweat it too much. If you can't get it, you can get it online. This was something that turned up on Reddit. I was looking around some Reddit threads and managed to find this a very cool looking piece there. This is a Funko Pop vending machine. Found at MegaCon in Florida. It's actually branded on the side, The Pop Shop. Collectible vinyl figures by Funko. So you go on and nobody mentioned anymore. I believe it's you choose one of these six that are shown up there. A Batman, a Superman, Wonder Woman, kind of classic standard stuff, a Groot, things like that. And yeah, that was it. So I don't think it was anything too exclusive, but still nice to see. Imagine that in malls and things, eh? That'd be kind of
Do they
cool.
have a slot where you can return a damaged box one?
That's true. Or say the paint job isn't no good on this. So that could be one of those things. So if you're a DC fan, and I know you are, although I don't know whether you're a Teen Titans fan. Big Teen Titans
No.
fan? No? Yeah.
No. What the
No.
hell is that?
I know. Brand new from Funko. These are Toys R Us exclusives. This is Batman Flashette. I don't know quite what's going on there. I've never seen the Teen Titans, to be honest. This is not Wonder Woman. It's someone as Wonder Woman. I know that for a fact. Raven.
Raven.
That's who it is, yeah. Raven as Wonder Woman, looking very pale and kind of like a Hot Topic customer, really. Oh, that's a bit edgy.
Pretty much, yeah.
Kind of Goth Central.
And then
But
Starfire is the Flash.
Starfire is a Flash. That's what it is. That's
And
beautiful. I
Robin
really
is
like that. That's nice.
Batman. Yeah, those aren't so bad.
So yeah, there's three of them. Toys R Us exclusives for some reason.
That's
Kind of
because that's the
unusual.
only place you've been able to get the Teen Titans pops in a long, long time.
I don't know why, it's very limited. The show seems to be quite popular, but yeah, Teen Titans Go. If you're into them, that's where you can get them. And again, if you guys are watching this and you see something that we've missed out on, let us know. Please just drop us an email or tweet or Instagram, or we'll give you the addresses in the show or leave a note on this YouTube video. Now, Deadpool. You talked about Deadpool before. You and I get a little pissed off with the Hot Topic mystery reveals and everybody spoils it. Maybe you didn't know this, but there's yet another Deadpool on the way. We talked about the suit and tie version, but this one turned up. Have you seen this?
Yeah,
Have you?
that's one of the
Have you?
mystery ones.
Is that one of
Yeah.
the mystery ones? I
Yeah.
did not see this. So,
Doesn't matter. No one gives a damn.
really?
I
Oh, I
mean,
thought this.
well, I see you're on my buddy Pop Wars Instagram page. So yeah, if you guys want pop news, that's the guy to go see.
He's definitely got a lot of cool stuff.
But yeah, that's the Stingray and all that came out with, yeah, that's what that was. But yeah, I don't give a damn.
Yeah, he's got a very good pop account, and we'll talk about some more of that stuff in just a minute. This was another one that turned up here in Australia. This is the, and I don't know whether it'll make its way to the US or not. I'm sure it will. Bronze Patina Wonder Woman, exclusive to the Supernova Sydney and Melbourne Comic Cons that run over here in Australia. You'll also be able to get it, I believe, on popculture.com.au for those of you who can't get it overseas. But kind of nice looking finish on that. I wish they'd do that with some other figures. There's other ones that would work really well in that mold. But I'm sure we had patina finishes in the past. I can't remember offhand who.
The Dark Knight,
Did
the
they?
Christian Bale Batman, Cthulhu, Rocketeer,
Cthulhu, that's what it was. Yep, Cthulhu, that's a good one.
Rocketeer, and I think that's it. I wouldn't be surprised if we saw a Power Armor one in the future.
Yeah, that's true. So, just a few more pops and things to come along. We talked about Arrow. We talked about, oh, there's a bunch of other exclusives here we're just going to talk about in just a second. Just open some links here. So, one that popped up, and everybody proverbially did lose their shit over this one because of the availability issue on it, and it's just coming up on screen. It was Cosmo, Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmo, the dog who you see for about 3 seconds in Guardians of the Galaxy, has a pop made for him. I don't. Did you see with this or hear about this kind of the limited release on this?
No, I didn't.
No. So
But it
this
looks
is
really
a.
good.
It does look really good. So it's going to be Marvel. It's a bobblehead, but it is marked as a speciality series. And what this means is large stores such as EE, Dark Side Toys, all of these places that have had exclusives or carry exclusives recently will not be able to get this. It's only smaller little comic shops. Pop culture is getting some, bizarrely, but again, they're outside of the US, so that doesn't really count. And that's where I would recommend you get it, because this thing's already going up for like $29 on eBay. This is Australian money, so that's about $11 US, something like that, $18.99. But cool looking, cute little pop, and people were just going bananas for this thing. So, yeah. You're not going to find this everywhere, so if you want to get it, it's definitely one to hunt down quickly. You think you'll pick one up? You're a fan of that, you think?
Oh, definitely. Cosmo?
Yeah.
Cosmonaut from Agents of Atlas? Yeah. Yeah. I love the dog is way, way more entertaining in the movie than Howard the Duck was.
Yes.
That's right, I said it.
That's true. No, I agree with you. I double that. Well, Arrow was a good popular TV show online, and this turned up on one of the actors who's played several roles in the show, Goody and Baddie. But he's turned up here, and we don't know yet whether this is a custom or not, but if you're an Arrow fan, this may well be a pop that's coming. It wouldn't surprise me. He's one of the main characters, and we've got a few other characters to get. But if you're into that, keep an eye out for that Arrow pop. Another couple of things that turned up, FYE, again, one of those stores that basically there's hardly any left, I think, really, in the States.
Yeah, how the hell does FYE keep getting all these exclusives when they don't have any stores open?
I don't know. Well, I guess they have online, so it's an online store as well.
Yeah.
But for your entertainment, a very kind of niche US online e-tailer and slightly dying retailer, but then again, retail's kind of dying everywhere. But they're getting a slightly different version of Rowan's Ghost. Really indistinguishable because they're both white, but this one glows in the dark. So if you're into that, that's one other one you can get. This one caught my eye. I thought you might like this. Again, another exclusive. What's with the deal with the white here? I'm not quite sure what's going on.
Okay, well, they were going to do black and white ones as like an homage to the comic book with have different colored bandanas. So 3 years ago, two or three years ago, they did Raphael or Michelangelo, and they haven't done any since. So now you can get, they're going to be able to get the rest of them, but you're going to have to pay $50, $60, $75 to get the other one. So yeah, thanks Funko. It should just be an Amazon exclusive, just put all four of them in one box, black and white.
I must admit, when it's an Amazon exclusive, it's very fair. Everybody around the globe can pretty much get it, and it's a reasonable price. So it's always a nice, fair thing that way, but that's just my point of view. Only a couple of other things. That's pretty much all the pop mainline news that I could find and dig up. Anything you've heard about we haven't covered in terms of recent new pop?
No, just still waiting on glam shots of the Mega Man stuff that's coming out. That's the next thing I'm most excited about. And then, but God, the pre-order list gets bigger every day, and you see something new every time. So, yeah, just a lot of good stuff on the horizon. A lot of good non-bobblehead stuff.
Yes, there is. That's true. There is a bunch of that stuff. There is a bunch of Star Wars pops we know are coming. A lot of stuff's been leaked out. Still no images, but there are really plenty of pops to come in that line, in that range. Just having a look while I'm here, and if this tab would open up. That's pretty much, as I said, all the kind of main news we can think of. It's not going to open. Never mind. We'll come back to that. So one other thing that we'll move on to is a little bit of some custom stuff. This caught my eye on my Instagram feed. I mean, they're all boxed, but wow, what a display. He's got tons of these things. Probably not that many once you lay it all up, but I mean, it looks pretty impressive. I love seeing people's pop displays and the way they've laid them out. I have to say I like yours better with the display out of the box and the box too, but some nice pieces there. A lot of cool stuff going on that pop, and that's from Fugly16 on Instagram. But yeah, nice, cool pop collections. Plenty of cool stuff going on there. What other stuff do we have a couple of other things here, just some customs. Saw this on Pop Price Guide, this pretty cool statue of Spider-Man. Someone's kind of, I think, got fed up with the mold of Spider-Man that is out there, and they've based this off of an old Sideshow collectible statue. And they have made this. Let's blow this up and you can see a little better. There we go. A nice little touch they've done there. Based, as I said, off this, I should have showed it around. There's the original Spider-Man statue. And someone's fallen in love with it and decided, let's make a pop version of it. I must admit, I'm really getting a bit a little fed up with that old Spider-Man. We've seen it just so many times, and it's so desperate. He's such a core character. So nice to see that they've remolded and somebody's made a kind of fan custom version of it. I like that.
Very, very nice. That's really cool. That's really well done. I like that.
Nice display as well on the wall and stuff. So yeah, nice little touch. I think that's it for customs. Anything else in my notes? Let me have a little look. One more, and that's covered as well. No, I think that's it. We'll have a quick look at pop culture just as we do this show live. Let's see if there's anything else that's came out while we've been talking, because that is not unusual for Funko. Let's be helpful if I shared this on screen. So there's a bunch of stuff here by pre-order. Let's sort this and see if there's anything coming out that we've maybe missed. What have we got? Period of date. Yeah, we're pretty much covered. I think we're pretty much up to date. The Arrow stuff we talked about, the Speedy. We haven't really touched on these, the Rock Candy things, but I think we can skip them. It's not really our kind of core stuff. We talked about Popstars the last time too. So I think that's pretty much it. The pens, there's a few Funko pen toppers coming as well for Star Wars, but I think that's us. What are you buying, sir?
Did we talk about the disguise? Yeah, we talked about this Batman already.
Yeah, I think we did. I think we talked about the Popstars before. But
Stuff I got? I've actually got some stuff.
What'd you buy?
First of all, I had to get the Ant-Man.
Giant-Man.
Nice. I mean, Giant-Man. And I did look and compare him, and his suit is different, so I'm not totally mad about it. I really like this pop.
Me too. It's good.
And it goes perfect next to my Thanos and Hulkbuster. So, and then
I was just going to see if you've got the regular Ant-Man pop, and then if you buy the upcoming little keychain, you get a nice little display.
Well, and I've got the little bitty mini one from Collector's Core. So yes, I'm. Nice. There'll be an Instagram picture coming very soon of yeah. My local Hot Topic got three of the new DC figures pops in, so I got Supergirl. Which is it's pretty well done. This Firestorm, very very cool.
He is cool.
And then Cyborg.
Yeah, like.
I really wanted to see a Power Girl in person, to see if she had like a really big chest for a pop. And then I'm very excited about the Black Manta. I can't wait to see that in person. But I think that's all I've gotten as of late.
Cool. I've pre-ordered a bunch of stuff. Just ridiculous amounts of stuff. Just looking at the show notes, I'm trying to remember what I've pre-ordered, but there's been a lot. Ghostbusters keychains. In fact, I've got them in hand just there. Let me just show them. So there's cool little Slimer and Steampuff guys. Very nice little pieces. What else did I get? A couple of older ones I managed to find here, which are on kind of like versions of eBay and stuff over here. A little Pop Rocketeer, $10. Classic older one that I had before and I got rid of stupidly.
People just crap their pants that you said you got a Rocketeer for $10.
I know, they'll probably go mad. But again, it's different outside the US. It's just it's a different world. I think I talked about that the last time, the Addict Driver. Again, they're not Walgreens exclusives here, they're just available everywhere. But he's selling pretty fast. Terrible paint job on some of them, so yeah, watch out. This one was one I was always after for a long time. This is Island Scarred Oliver Queen. I'm not generally into half-naked dudes, but trying to get this pop for a long time was really, really tough. I think it was a Fugitive Toys in the US or UK. So I can't remember who had this.
It was Fugitive Toys. Fugitive Toys had Diggle as Green Arrow.
Diggle, that's what it was, yeah. So that's one that I still don't have, but I'm just not going to pay a lot of money for it.
I just noticed your Funko hoodie.
Funko hoodie, yeah, got that before I left the US, so yeah. That's
okay.
Very cool. They're very cool. They're still available on Funko.com, so.
Well, it is not cold here.
But, so some of the sites that are out here, I mean, again, I just tried a lot of smaller stores and niche stuff here. I posted it on on Instagram about some Funko stuff, but there's a couple of little night markets and they sell some rare and hard to find pop. It's a ton of stuff, but managed to find that on a New Zealand site. So if you're really, really hunting for some of those exclusives, you can't get them in the US, you don't mind paying that a little bit more, hunt around. The UK, Australia, New Zealand all have sites that stock a lot of pop and they're not exclusive, so you can get hold of those holes in your collection if you're really desperate for them. I think that's us. Any other Funko Pop news, mini mysteries, Dorbs, anything you want to tell people about?
No, I don't think so. I haven't had time to get really into it. I cannot tell you how many pops I've talked myself out of lately, though. It's getting out of hand. I passed on a Chase Smog the other day.
That's pretty bad for you not to pick that up.
Okay. Well, I got the gold one, and it was Get Smog or the Giant Man and Giant Man.
Yeah.
So, but no, it's just. A lot of stuff. I want people to chime in. Like, tell us what you're buying. I want to see your displays. Like, tweet me. ARTKEM_. If you're not on Twitter, get on there. Even if you don't have to tweet, but there's all our news, it's Twitter. You find out stuff that happens before it's on the news on Twitter, like anything. Get on Twitter, tweet us, let us know what you're buying, show us. I want to see it. I want to see your displays. I want to see your first pop. Like, I want to interact. Fly Guy sees all the stuff on the YouTube videos. I don't see it all that much. So you guys tweet me, email me, like, feel free to chat. I love talking about stuff. Ask Steve Hutto. Hutto reached out, and it wasn't weird. We didn't treat him like shit. Real cool guy. So if you guys want to talk to me, I don't know if Fly Guy's busy. He's not busy. But, yeah, if you guys... If you guys want to talk about anything, we collect everything, whatever, tweet at us. Yeah, we want more interaction. Be lying if I said we didn't want more views and stuff like that. But, just help us spread the message. If you're on Periscope and you're typing on there, just start saying Pop Recap just over and over. I did it the other day and somebody told me to shut up, but I kept doing it.
That's it. We're encouraging you to spam the shit out of everybody. No, we're not.
Yeah. Yeah,
we do this because we love it, but San Diego Comic Con is literally around the corner. We're going to be flooded with information, so we'll have another show soon enough and plenty of stuff to talk about. It's always a huge thing for Funko to release information and catalogs at this time. So yeah, you're gonna see a lot of Funko Pop stuff. So I think, like you, I'm trying to be a little bit more selective and choosy on what I buy because there's just too much stuff.
Yeah,
so, and add that with Marvel Legends and NECA. And Hot Toys and Lego. Oh boy. Oh boy. It's just too much. It's too much. Anyway, where can people find you? You're also on Instagram too, and what's your handle?
Artkem, ARTKEM, and it's the same on Twitter, except there's an underscore after. So find me there. I'm on Facebook. I've got a Facebook page, but I don't really use it that much because whatever. But yeah.
I'm the same. Facebook sucks.
Twitter, Instagram, it should be on the show notes. If not, it's 6 letters. So.
I'm sure they can manage that. We'll put a link in the show notes as well. So thank you to, yes, Steve as well. We're still amazed at that generosity you had, and we'll still sort you out. Don't worry, give it time. Yes, thank you for that. And if you want to subscribe, you've got all these little podcasts and Funko News straight from myself and Arkham. We'll be back as soon as we can with another show. We'll see you soon.
Wubba lubba dub dub.